4 years of second place. 4 years of Vice President Jefferson. But not for long. It's 1800. Time to let the people speak. This country will be mine.
I had learned during my first term that the president's job isn't exactly easy, but I had survived. Now I was faced with a battle even I couldn't win. Jefferson had people in the right places, but I wasn't ready to just lay down and take it.
I've got a country to save.
Time. This is the place.
John Marshall, why would a lawman traverse these woods?
Why would a financier? I suppose you're here for the same reason I am.
Federalism! And the future of this nation! Up! This isn't England!
But Mr. President, why?
You know why. Jefferson grows stronger every day. Him and his forces. These are dangerous times, men.
Surely there's enough strength in Federalist strongholds to carry the day. Massachusetts!
Don't waste your breath, Marshal. Abigail keeps me warm at night. And Massachusetts is a fine state. I need muscle. That's where you come in.
But I don't understand. How could a lawyer take the place of a president?
You did fine in our little trouble with the French, John. Just stick with me. Jefferson can't touch you.
But Mr. President, why did you call me here? We disagree so often.
Surely, as Federalists, there are some things we can still agree on. We both know Jefferson is trying to yoke this country to his will.
He is despicable, I'll give you that.
There are whispers that he's even enlisting the aid of one Aaron Burr.
Aaron Burr is a fiend! A mongrel!
And a menace to the United States. I summoned you here, Alexander Hamilton, because I respect you. Because I know that in your heart, you are a Federalist.
Federalist!
I'm with you, Adams.
My apology may come too late. But I fear some of my writings may have damaged your campaign.
That's behind us now, Hamilton. Marshal, gentlemen, patriots, our work is in the present.
Get the kids out of the house, Sally. I'm having company.
You requested a meeting?
Yes, sir, my friend.
Not your friend. Got anything to drink?
Well, you see, I consider myself a connoisseur of sorts of fine French wine.
Please.
Well, Burr, my boy.
I'm not your boy. Don't address me as such.
Well, Mr. Burr. You see, we have some business to discuss.
Yeah.
For you see, running an election is very expensive.
Yeah.
And, well, I need more money. Stupid kids. Should've got rid of them. But
I funded your campaign. I promised you New York. Now you're asking me for more. Remind me again, what's in it for me?
Power, Aaron. Power.
Thank you so much.
Power beyond your wildest and most extravagant dreams.
Now that's something I can understand.
Yes, the vice presidency will be yours, with compensation worthy of that noble office.
All right. I'm convinced. But what do you need all this money for, anyway?
Well, let's just say I've come across some extra expenses. One might even call them extra constitutional expenses.
I thought you were a strict constructionist.
So much for that.
The remaining weeks leading up to the election confirmed Jefferson's advantage. His platform had a certain appeal to working rural folk.
The noble
yeoman. Thomas Jefferson, by the way.
Well, he denounced my firm, Just Governments. The contest was practically over before it began.
Election day. I'm almost surprised not to see a guillotine anywhere.
John, I've just received word.
I know. The Democratic Republicans clawed their way into the White House, didn't they?
Yes. And they've taken the legislature as well.
I figured as much.
John, I would have expected you to be more disappointed. How can America survive with a despotic fool like Jefferson in the White House?
I am disappointed. Disappointed in democracy. But surely you remember the bleakest days of my presidency, when I sought the counsel of George Washington. He told me an account of his winter in Valley Forge with the Continental Army. And suddenly all my problems seemed about as harrowing as a trip to the post office. And Jefferson hasn't counted on all the tricks I still have up my sleeve.
Won't you miss the White House?
Nah, I prefer the Massachusetts climate. And I really could use a little more privacy. After all, my most important office is the one I'm not elected to.
You have my vote anyway.
Do you see how badly I want that stupid brute Adams? I mean, really. He didn't stand a chance. Oh.
I have an urgent message for Vice President Jefferson.
You mean President-elect Jefferson, don't you?
I don't believe it's that simple.
What?